Hello, welcome to our channel for doing statistics using R. In this video, we will show how to use Poisson distribution in R. So Poisson distribution is used to model the discrete number X, so which is occurring time in a Poisson experiment. The Poisson experiment is model of occurring times in with a constant rate in specified time interval. Although this time interval can be also, for example, distance, area, or volume of interest. So in a specified, for example, 10 hours, we have average, so this is mu, average occurring times with lambda t. Here t is 10 hours, and the lambda is for average occurring rate for 1 hour. So in this 10 hours, the mu is average occurring time. And we want to use Poisson distribution to model the probability of occurring x times in this 10 hour. So the Poisson distribution's probability function for px with a lambda t, also called mu, equals the division of E minus lambda t, so E minus mu in power times mu or lambda t x in power divided by x factorial. So x can be discrete number from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And Poisson distribution's mean and variance both equal to lambda t, so both equal to mu here. So in R, if you want to use Poisson distribution, you can use D, P-O-I-S, or P-O-I-S, Q-P-O-I-S, or R-P-O-I-S. These four functions are for the density or probability function, cumulative distribution function, and a quantile function, and random number generation. So next we will show how to use these functions in RStudio. So first, we will show the function dpois. This will calculate the probability of a random variable such as available within a certain range. So for example, dpois 10, which means the probability of occurring 10 times in a Poisson experiment. This experiment, for this time interval, the average occurring times is 10. So dpois uses k lambda. So here lambda equals lambda t in point we have shown. So here lambda is actually is a mu. So the function use k and mu. K is for the x occurring times which of interest. So dpois 10 is about 0.125. So this probability is about 1/8. It's not very low because average occurring time is 10, right? So occurring 10 has about 0.125 in probability. So next, if average occurring time is 15 for this time interval, then what's the probability of occurring 2? So we use dpois 2, 15. It's quite low, almost zero. So next, we will create a vector from 1 to 20. Then we'll show the result of the Poisson probability of this vector in a Poisson experiment with average occurring times is 10. Then we plot this probability. So for average time 10 in a Poisson experiment, this figure shows the probability for different discrete occurring times, you can see the highest probability close to the 10 and about over 15, here 0.04, very low, and for the average time 5, also about 0.04. The second function we want to show is PPORS. This function will calculate the probability of the cumulative probability of the random variable, which will be equal to or less than a number. So PPORS will calculate the probability of all the random number occurring and all the random number less than or equal to this Q. So for example, PPORS will calculate all the cumulative probability for all the random variable less than 10 in this Poisson experiment with average occurring time 10. So it's about 0.58. And the cumulative probability of occurring 0, 1, 2 is about 3.93 with E minus 0.5, also very low. So next we will also create a vector from 1 to 20, then plot the cumulative probability of this vector, which represents the random number in this Poisson process with average occurring time 10. So now you can see for 10, random number 10, its cumulative probability is about 0.6. So which means almost 60% of the probability that will occur with the random number less than or equal to 10 in this Poisson process. So the third function is called QPORS. So this function is actually the opposite operation of the PPORS. So this will be used for generating quantile of a given Poisson's distribution. So this function will have input of cumulative probability, then will calculate the random number. So for example, Poisson for the QPORS 0.210 will calculate the random number with the cumulative probability of 0.2. So it's 7. And QPORS 0.715 is about 17. Now similarly, we will create a probability vector first from 0.1 to 1. Then we will calculate the quantile number from this vector of probability and plot in the figure. So here the horizontal axis is for the probability. So here 2 means 0.2. From 0 to 10 divided by average interval. So this is 0.2, 0.6. So 0.6 has the value almost 11. So this means in this Poisson process, about 60% of the random number will be less than or equal to 11. So the last function called rprogramming is used for generating random numbers from a given Poisson distribution. So rprogramming, here n is 20, we will generate 20 random number from this Poisson distribution. And this Poisson distribution has mu or lambda t equals 10. So you can see 20 discrete random numbers are generated from this Poisson distribution. You can also download all the source files from this GitHub link, and more videos on doing statistics using R will be uploaded later on YouTube. Thanks for watching.